there is a massively useful update inside of Photoshop that almost nobody's talking about. Adobe have completely redone the algorithm and the way that the AI selections work inside of the object selection tool. This will really change the way you make selections. So we're going to do a comparison between object selection and select subject. But first of all, let's have a look and see how it works and what makes the object selection a little bit different. So if we go into the regular, you know, tools here, I call these the magic tools. We could be an object selection, quick select, or magic wand. You know, we'll go into the object selection. So first of all, we're going to do a select subject. So let's go to the drop down and we want to choose cloud. This is always going to give us a better selection. Only time you wouldn't choose cloud is if you're not connected to the internet. And we're going to choose select subject. And if you look at this, you'll notice it's selected the three women in the foreground. I'm going to hit Control D to turn it off. But when we go to the object selection tool and we have object finder turned on, so as you roll over each one of these objects, you're going to see an outline. So what makes this different is we can select the individual people. So we could select, say, the first woman by simply clicking. We'll see the selection. I'm going to hit Control J just, you know, for simplicity's sake. We'll use masks and stuff in a minute. And why don't we go back to that bottom layer? We'll select the second girl. Let's click on her. Control J. And let's go back to the background again. And we'll select the third. And notice that the updated algorithm, it's getting into these little gaps. It's getting in between the fingers and everything. But let's hit Control J. Now we're going to hide the background. All right, let's just go back to the Move tool. So you can see here, we're able to isolate each one of these separately. So the important thing about this tool is, number one, the ability to be able to select individual people. The next thing we can do is we're able to select individual objects from within a photograph. So when the object finder is on, we can roll over and we can see the different areas. In fact, if you want to see all the selectable areas, just hit this little icon up there and we can see those are all the individual areas that we can select. But what if we don't want to do that? We'll turn that off and we just want to make our own selections. Okay, so what I'm going to do is just turn off the object finder for a second. And we're going to use the rectangle. Say I want to select the tree, the palm tree. I just make a selection around it and notice that it makes that selection. And it doesn't even have to be a good selection. Let me do a rough selection here. Notice that we're missing bits and it will actually grow to make that selection. So if I want to add to that selection, I can hold down the shift key and let's grab that red car and it will select that as well. Now we can go in and customize this by using the lasso tool and say I hold down the shift key and I want to add this irregular shape to it. Let's go there and, you know, it's selected that area. Now if we want to exclude the middle, hold down the alt or the option key for the minus and let's see if we can exclude that middle part. And as you can see there, that's a pretty good selection. Let me just create a mask and you can see we can create a great mask without a lot of effort. And if you're getting any value out of this video, hit that subscribe button, turn on notifications. You won't miss any of my videos. So what we're going to do here is we're going to do a comparison between the two AI selections, select subject and object selection. And yes, they are different. So why don't we start with select subject? We're going to go into the object selection mode and we're going to go down to cloud, which is going to give us the best quality. And we're going to use select subject. So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to create a layer mask and that'll give us the cutout. All right, let's call the top one select subject. And now I've reset this and now we're going to use the object selection. So let's go back to the object selection tool. We're going to turn on object finder. And you'll notice that this little gear will turn. If it doesn't, just click on there and you can force it to examine the image. And as we roll over, we can see we can just click once to make a selection. Now, understand, I'm not refining these selections in any way. There are tools in Photoshop to make these selections better. What we want to do is just look at the starting place. So I'm just going to click on the mask here, and we have the object selection. So let's compare these with different color backgrounds. Now, understand, I have no vested interest for one to be better than the other. We're purely just going to look at them and see how good the improvements are. So comparing both of these, they look kind of similar at first glance. But let's look at things like the eyelash. On the left, it looks like it did a better job of the eyelash using the object selection than select subject. The hair, it looks like select subject got more of the hair, whereas the object selection actually did a better job of trying to separate between the hair. and cut out the holes. But if we compare this now on something like a white, you can see the eyelash is not so obvious anymore. Actually looks quite good. Of course, this one does look better. And let's zoom into 100%, so I'm going to double click and we're going to scroll over. Okay, not bad. Far from perfect. But remember, we haven't made any refinements to these selections. The black sometimes will reveal a halo, which we can see around the hair on this particular one. They're pretty close, but in this case, I think we can say that the new algorithm in the object selection is just as good, if not better, than select subject. The smooth edge is actually really good. Unfortunately, it looks like some little bits got missed on the skateboard. Over here on select subject, the bottom part of your back is actually better than the object selection. All right, so let's just move on quickly. I want to show you the basic features of this. The features are not new, just the algorithm is brand new. But let me show you how it works. When you're in here and you want to select something, Object Finder is off. You roll over the photo, it doesn't do anything. Object Finder is on. We roll over and areas that can be selected will appear underneath your cursor. To select those, you click. If we click on the second option here, this will show all the selectable areas at once. All right, we're not going to labor under these settings, but let's just quickly look at the main ones. Auto a manual refresh. If you put it in manual refresh, that means when you're compositing or working or changing anything in the photos, it's not going to keep updating. You'll just click that and it will update it. If you have it on auto refresh, as you're working, it's going to keep updating, and that can sometimes get in the way. Change the color that we want of the outline. And we can also change the outline amount. So you can have a very thin outline if you want. Like say we wanted to maybe do a red outline, have a thinner outline if you find those thick outlines are kind of getting in your way. And of course we can also change the opacity of that. So we could drop the opacity way down. So you just kind of maybe change that from a red to something like a yellow. And here we now just kind of get a hint that something can be selected without it being so distracting. All right, just reset these to make it a little bit more visible. But when we're in an always show, it doesn't matter where you are, it's going to constantly show the areas that can be selected. We can turn it to never show, so that means it won't show when you roll over. However, you can still click to select different parts of the image, so it's still going to be functional without being distracting. And then, of course, the other option is the standard option, which is auto, which means that as you roll over the image, you see it, roll away, you don't see it. Okay, and let me quickly show you how you would refine the selection. So we would go into the object select tool, we would roll over our subject, and we click, like we've done before, that loads our selection. Now, this time we're going to go into the select and mask. Turn the transparency all the way up. And it's actually done a really good job of his coat and stuff, but you might see the edges are looking a little rough. So we can kind of fix this by changing the radius to 1. And I'm going to just give this a slight little bit of feather. And then we can push the contrast just a little bit. And if you see by doing that, we can get a much better, cleaner job of these edges in the smooth areas such as his skin. Now, to fix the hair, what you want to do is grab the refine brush. Have a look, we're going to go around this area here. And as we roll over the refine brush, notice it fills in those areas that are getting missed. Let me make that a little bit bigger. And it can actually do a pretty good job of restoring this hair. And this works on things like hair, feather, smoke, glass, semi-transparent areas. And let's go back in here, make sure this is nice and solid now. And notice with the addition of that refine brush, we have got a much better result there. Why don't I just put this against a different color background so you can see? Let me put this against an overlay. And we'll turn the opacity up so you can see it clearly. Watch what happens when I hit decontaminate colors. Boom. Fills it out nicely. And if it goes too far, what you can do is you can roll back the amount and just dial in the amount of decontamination that you want. This will get rid of a lot of the edge halos. You know, when you have the white or the black edges. At this point, we would choose a new layer for layer mask. Click OK. And now we've got a pretty good cutout. And if you want to refine your selections more, check out my other video where I have 5 secrets for getting better selection edges. If you're new to Photoshop Cafe, hit the subscribe button, turn on notifications, and you won't miss any of my new tutorials, and I've got a lot of exciting ones coming. Until next time, I'll see you at the cafe.